Okay guys, it's time to brew the Cooper's Mexican Cerveza, and we're going to do that with Cooper's Brew Enhancer for a creamier head with enhanced body and mouth feel. This is a 1 kilogram pack, and you basically just put this in the fermenter. Mix it with the hot water, make sure it disappears, then add the Cooper's, give it a good stir, fill up with water, add the yeast, which is take the lid off, it's here, which is 7 grams net, and once that's done, we'll leave it for a good 7 days, and hopefully we'll have a really nice brew. The instructions, just the normal stuff really, nothing exciting. I followed these loads of times before, but and we're brewing that now. So that's the Cooper's Mexican Cerveza, the Brew Enhancer 1, and the Cooper's Brewing Yeast. That's what we're going to stick in. So let's do that now. Right, I've took my label off my tin. I've got 2 pans, one for the main mix. When I pour the this in with the weather wort, this first one, I'm gonna drop your tin in, soften it up, and we'll come back to that in about 10 minutes. But first of all, I'm gonna open this bad boy. Bag of our Brew Enhancer 1, and that's going to be added into the fermenter, and then once that's in the fermenter, we'll pour this hot water in, then the wort, then some more water, fill it up, and eventually give it, after a good stir, add the yeast. Simple as. You can't really get any easier than a kit and a can, a kit and a kilo. Lovely jubbly. Okay, so it's time to get the fermenting vessel that's been sanitised, and we're going to add the Brew Enhancer first. Brew Enhancer 1 kilogram. Then we're going to add the water. Put the kettle on. Give this a shake. And just to show you, pull this off, and we can add the wort. Thank you. happy with that. No can do. Get the dregs. Get the spoon. Do a good whirl. Put it back on the side lid. I'm going to get this and pour it in the bucket. Don't know if I'll do it one-handed. Probably not. I'll tell you what we'll do. Lovely, lovely. And then we'll fill it up with water. So about 23, so just a little over 20. At your height. Absolutely lovely smell. If only it smelled like that when you were drinking it. So we'll take it up to about 20. Give it a stir. Take a temperature reading. Take it up to 23 after we'd adjusted water. So we get the temperature about the right the right ballpark. Take up with gravity reading. Pitch the yeast. Job done. It's about 25. Well, it was 30. When I took it out of the bucket, so it needs to come down a little bit, so we're just going to add some more water. The minute it's at 21 litres, so it needs to be a 23, so we'll top it up to 23 with cold water, and that should bring it to exactly the right temperature that we need. Now, the Cooper's kit instructions say that ideally it should be between 21 and 27 degrees Celsius, which is about 70 to 80 Fahrenheit, so that's what we're aiming for. So we'll add some more water and then hopefully we'll take a reading and see what it comes up with. So the hydrometer reading saying about 40. That's 1040. So we'll take a note of that. It's about where it should be really. And then that'll give us when we come to bottle up roughly what percentage it is. So bang on, spot on. Okay, time to give it a final stir. Temperature is spot on. And time to add the yeast. This is Cooper's yeast. There we go. Gonna sprinkle it in as it's spinning. And we're gonna give it a bit of a dab. Once we'll give it a dab, we'll give it a good stir. And all that's left to do is pop the lid on and leave for a good 7 days. And time for the airlock, and then that's it.